Do you like burst characters? Do you like being flexible in your range in combat? And do you not like to focus on trying to get a headshot, but rather spam out your shots and try to get a kill that way? Then the Mage might be for you. This is a beginner guide for the Mage in Realm Royale. Since the latest patch, the Mage is by many considered the strongest class in the game, so it's a good moment to take a look at this character and see what she can offer. In this guide, we'll go over what the Mage is particularly good or bad at, how the passive and the abilities and the legendary weapon work, and how the Mage can generally be played. We begin with the Mage's strength. The Mage excels at quite a few things. At the moment, between the Fireball and the legendary weapon, the Mage has the highest non-headshot burst in the game. The immediate damage that you can deal between the ability and your weapon is only outclassed by the sniper from the assassin if you get a headshot. Furthermore, the Mage is very good across all ranges. Not only does her main damaging ability fly in a straight line until it crashes in a wall, but also the legendary weapon has quite a decent solid range on it with no damage drop-off. While it's still projectile based, the weapon fires multiple shots, so there's a good chance you can land at least one of them at long ranges. The Mage is also pretty solid at self-sustain and defense, and has multiple abilities that can in one way or another protect the Mage from incoming shots or projectiles. And last but not least, depending on which abilities are leveled, she also has a solid amount of setup with her explosive flask. The Mage is not entirely without weaknesses though. While her mobility ability is great for getting around buildings or to top floors quickly and even avoid enemies in combat that way, it is also not exactly an in-combat mobility ability. Different from, for example, the Hunter's Roll or the Assassin's Blink that will give you some quick immediate mobility in combat. While soaring as a Mage, you can still easily be hit with abilities. On the other hand, there's also the downside of spell dependency. There are certain spells, abilities on the Mage that are simply better than others, and if you're crafting legendary ones, then you really depend on your luck to get the right one. Other classes often don't have this problem because either they're not as dependent on their abilities, or their abilities are more of similar strength. That's not true for the Mage. And that brings us to the Mage's abilities. The first one is the passive. This is probably the weakest part of the kit, and also the weakest passive that we have among all classes. All this passive does is it increases the potion effectiveness by 30%. That can be good in some situations when you quickly need to heal up with potions, but generally in combat passives just seem like the much better option, or some passives sort of sustain, and every other class has something like that, so the Mage is lacking behind here a little bit, but that's maybe because the rest of the Mage's kit is very strong, so a weaker passive kind of compensates for that a little bit. When playing in squads or duos, this is something worth keeping in mind. Consider dropping some of your potions for the allies, they may need some more than you do. Next, we'll go right over to the abilities. Here, we're gonna start with the weakest and then work our way up to the strongest. The weakest ability of the Mage, without a doubt, is Wall. The Wall simply places a small wall on the map. This wall cannot be seen or shot through by anyone, so it is as much as an advantage and disadvantage for you as it is for the enemy. Depending on the rank of the wall that you have, the cooldown will be shorter and the duration will be longer. On the lowest rank, the cooldown is 14 seconds and the duration is 3 seconds. On the longest rank, the cooldown is 8 seconds and the duration is 9 seconds. Now, in theory, there could be some use for the wall to block enemies off from your stealth and then use potions behind the wall while being safe. The problem is, once again, the wall is relatively small, and really, there isn't many places where this works effectively. When you're in a building, enemies usually have the option to go through another window or through another door. When you're outside, the wall is really just a small wall and enemies can just go around it. And as such, the uses for this ability are extremely niche. I'm not saying they're completely non-existent, but I've never found myself trying to get a higher rank wall in late game over any other ability of the Mage. Even if you were to try some cheese strat like 4 mages and everyone walls one side and then you are in this barrier of walls and you all heal up, you still have to keep in mind that on the lowest rank the duration is just 3 seconds and then just 5 seconds, and only on the higher ranks you will 7 or 9 seconds, so most of the time even that wouldn't be worth it. There have been many things that have been proposed to buff the wall in one way or another, for example reflecting projectiles or making it see-through for the Mage, but until that happens I don't think there's much value in this ability. The next ability is one that is valued a little bit higher, but not as highly as the others, and that is Explosive Flask. Now, Explosive Flask is not terrible. The ability deals 200 damage and you throw a flask on the ground that will then slow enemies. There are two different descriptions for the slow here. I am not quite sure which one is accurate at the moment. One is from a quick write-up by Dryber, the other one is from realm.gg. I think Dryber's one is the right one, and that would be that the slow is on 20 at the lowest rank, then 40, then 60, and then 80 on legendary, whereas realm.gg says 15, 30, 45, and 60. As Netshot has an up to 80% slow as well, I would think that the slow might be the same one here. The ability starts on a 12-second cooldown, but goes down to 6 seconds, and the duration of the slow apparently is 5 seconds, or at least 5 time units. As such, this is not bad. You have a strong slow combined with a little bit of damage at higher ranks. Many people say that the slow is just not worth it if you can aim, but I personally think as long as you're not using an aimbot and headshotting 100% of the time, there can always be value in having this slow to just hit all your shots more precisely if somebody is very slowed, or if you have a weapon for that, you can also just go for better headshots when you hit them with the explosive flask first. So I think there is still value even if you have good aim. The bigger downside for me personally is something else, and that is the weird projectile drop-off. Most abilities in Realm Royale are just straightforward projectiles that fly forward and then hit a barrier, and that's the way they work. That is manageable. Then in other games you have things like grenades that you throw up into the sky and then they drop down depending on how high you threw them at a further distance or shorter distance. That I also feel is something that feels manageable. The explosive flask is some weird in-between thing. You have to aim it a little bit above the character, but not too high in order to hit the slow, meaning that most of the time I feel at long ranges it feels super awkward to aim. At close ranges it's easier because you just throw it straight on the ground, but at any longer distance it just feels very clunky to me, and that is why I personally don't like explosive flask that much, even though I will pick it up if I get a legendary one and my ice block would be in a very low rank. And talking about ice block, we can move on to that ability. Ice block is one of the two most valued abilities for the mage. It makes you damage immune as long as you're frozen, and it heals you up during that time. The cooldown starts at 14 seconds, and on the highest rank it's 8 seconds. The duration goes up with every rank from 3 to 4 to 5 to 6 seconds. And you also heal in this ice block. You heal for 20 health every 0.2 seconds if RealmGG is correct, meaning you heal for 300 on the lowest rank and then 600 on the highest rank due to the longer duration. The ice block can be cancelled early if you want to throw off your opponents and get a quick shot in on them before they can react, because usually they expect the ice block to last quite a while because you're healing up in it. Ice block is mostly used defensively, either to block enemies' incoming damage or to heal yourself up. But it can be used offensively as well, and that is by abusing the fact that you won't be doing anything in the meantime, but your cooldowns still go lower. That means that you can use your damaging abilities, then use ice block, then wait until the cooldown of the damaging ability is over, and then unfreeze yourself and use the ability again right away. The combination of these three different aspects of blocking, damage, healing, and the aggressive usage makes it such a favorable ability. The other ability that is even more favored is the fireball. The fireball is a straight projectile. It deals 450 to 900 damage depending on the rank, and it has a cooldown that goes down from 10 seconds to 4 seconds at max rank. Even on the second highest rank, you have 750 damage on a 6 second cooldown, but obviously what you want to have is a 900 damage on a 4 second cooldown. As it is a straight projectile, you can just aim it like a normal shot, and it also has AoE damage, meaning it will hit targets that are just close to the projectile. That means even enemies hiding like right behind rocks can be hit by this ability if they're positioned poorly and the fireball flies right by them. Because of this high damage and this potential to poke out hiding enemies, most mage players try to get this before the legendary weapon. The thing is that this also leads to the gamble that I mentioned earlier. As you're gonna try and go for the legendary fireball, every other ability is not gonna be worth as much to you at that point. A legendary ice block will still be nice. Legendary explosive flask is still okay, but it's not what you're gonna go for. Apparently, I heard that the legendary wall doesn't even exist at the moment. I at least haven't seen it, as far as I can recall. So that makes it a little bit easier, but really the one you're looking for is the fireball. If you get it, you're suddenly ahead of everyone. If not, you might end up a lot weaker in the later stages of the game. Or you could obviously also end up with the mage's legendary mobility ability. So let's talk about that one a little bit. that is Soar. Soar starts at a 16 seconds cooldown and goes down to 10 seconds. With ranking it up, the duration also increases from 3 to up to 4.5 seconds. Since a recent patch, Soar allows you to fly through windows. Much like the ice block, Soar can be cancelled early by using it again. And overall, it's great mobility in early stages to quickly pick up items, to quickly go upstairs through a window and maybe catch an unsuspecting enemy that way. And in combat, it can also be used in that way. But again, the flight speed is not that fast, so enemies can still try and hit you mid-air. At the moment, we don't have any hit-scan weapons anymore, which makes it a little bit harder for them, but who knows what happens to that in the future. What's important to keep in mind with a mage's ability is that through a legendary helmet, you can also get further cooldown reduction. With that, you can get the fireball to less than 3 seconds cooldown and the flask to roughly 4 seconds cooldown, making the kit even more spammable. Last but not least, there is the mage's legendary weapon, the stone spear. This weapon has 5 shots and every single shot consists of 3 projectiles. Each projectile deals 300 damage, so you can deal up to 900 damage per shot. It's also one of the few projectiles that have a larger projectile size of 0.5, meaning it's a little bit easier to hit enemies with it. That means between the larger projectile size and the 3 shots, you have a decent chance to hit enemies at long range between 300 and 600 damage anyways. Again, as it stands, the fireball is a little bit better anyways, as you can still have another decent weapon plus the fireball damage over just the projectile damage from the stone spear, which is a little bit more unreliable, but we will see what happens to that in the future. Either way, it's a great short and long range and mid range weapon, so really nothing to complain about with this one. I've already mentioned a lot of the playstyle tactics, such as using the ice block to lower the cooldowns or using Soar to attack an enemy from above through a window, for example. But in general, it's also worth mentioning that you always want to try and chain your fireball with your normal shot for the maximum amount of burst whenever you can. Your positioning generally shouldn't actually be at the front of the fight, as your kit really doesn't have any benefits from being right in your enemy's face unless you really want to hit the explosive flask. But mid-range usually seems to be a pretty decent distance. At long-range fights, you're still good, but sometimes assassins or hunters can just do a better job. But in the end, it depends a lot on the situation overall as well. The mage, once again, is very flexible in all that. You have the same flexibility when it comes to your secondary weapon. You can either look for full-on close combat with a shotgun, or you can look for longer range damage with, for example, an heirloom. It really is up to you what you want to add, or if you even want to switch from the stone spear at all, if you have it. While I could most certainly expand on this, I feel like I've covered enough for a beginner guide, and you probably at this point just want to play the mage anyways. As such, I thank you guys very much for watching. If you're new to the channel, feel free to sub button and ring the bell, it really helps me out. Other than that, if you haven't checked out my other guides, there are quite a few already, the Warrior one and a General guide, and I will obviously add other class guides as well, so feel free to check those out. See you for the next one tomorrow. Duke Sloth, out.